Hi there, thanks for joining. My name is Mahesh Naik, and I'm a Principal Program Manager in the Azure Networking Organization. In this session today, I'm going to talk about how you can optimize connectivity for your traffic between your resources in Azure and the clients in the internet. To set some context, we see a significant increase in internet traffic globally for all our services. And that's because our customers are going through rapid digital transformation to accelerate their business growth, as well as to empower their employees. But also another big factor that is contributing to this huge increase in internet traffic is the current global health situation. The global health situation has dramatically changed the consumer behavior. The way we work, the way we live, the way we communicate, everything is now transformed, which is resulting to one incredible increase in overall internet traffic. I'm going to talk about some of the infrastructure capabilities that is built and optimized to provide you optimal internet connectivity experience. And also I'm going to talk about some of the services built in the platform that grants you more control, more flexibility, so you can optimize for your internet bound traffic. Let's start with the infrastructure. When it comes to internet facing workload, the global edge footprint plays a very important part in delivering seamless connectivity experience to your cloud resources. Edge footprint or the edge points of presence are where we connect our network to the rest of the internet. So this defines our network boundary. Traffic from Microsoft to internet goes through the edge POPs, and also traffic from internet, when it comes to Microsoft, it also comes through the edge POPs. Now, from the very beginning, we have adapted a design principle to place these edge POPs closer to the user so that we can observe the traffic as soon as possible, carry them in our own premium private backbone network all the way to the hosted service region. And then the return traffic also follows the same principle and exits our network closest to the user so that you get the premium optimal experience. Then comes the last mile optimization. So the last mile is the ISP network from our edge points of presence to the user in internet. To provide end-to-end optimal experience, we also need to optimize the last mile. So this is where Microsoft Peering Service comes into picture. The MAP service provides a platform to our ISP partners so that they can optimize the last mile so the mutual customers can get end-to-end connectivity experience, a good connectivity experience from all the way to the user location to the service hosted in the data center. Then I'm going to touch on global network. As some of you already know, Microsoft owns and operates one of the largest and most advanced private global network in the world. Microsoft has been consistently investing for the last 25 years and has built a network that is exceptionally highly reliable, secured, and highly available, and that enables you to connect to any of the Microsoft cloud services from anywhere in the world quickly and securely. Then I'm going to talk about a new service called Routing Preference. The service empowers you to choose the underlying network that will carry the traffic from Microsoft to the user or from the user to the service hosted in Microsoft. So you have the choice to optimize for the best performance, or if you want to choose the network that is more cost optimized. So you have that choice with Routing Preference. Along with the connectivity optimizations, there are a number of services that we have deployed in our edge locations. For example, Azure Frontier, Azure CDN, provide you a number of functionalities that you can leverage to optimize your web application. Functionalities such as application acceleration, SSL offload, global load balancing with instant failover, static content caching, security on the security front. You have the web application firewall, which is a layer 7 protection and protects your application from attacks such as SQL injection, cross-site scripting, and other layer 7 attacks. So there is a separate session scheduled for this one. If you are interested to learn more about these two services, Azure Frontier and Azure CDN, please join that session. It is pretty interesting. Let's dive into Azure Global Network. Our global network is the foundation of our network infrastructure. The map in the slide outlines the massive scale of the network. As you can see, there are 61 Azure regions, and it will continue to grow. And these regions are globally distributed. Microsoft Global Network connects all these regions and connects our data center to the rest of the internet via our edge points of presence. The network spans the globe with more than 165,000 fiber miles. And these are high capacity, fiber optics that includes both terrestrial as well as subsea optics. On the internet side, we have more than 180 edge POPs. And these edge POPs are strategically placed closest to the user so that we can observe the traffic as soon as possible and route them in our own private Microsoft global network, and you can get the premium experience. These edge POPs are connected to thousands of internet service providers across the world to provide the last mile experience. Besides Azure, this Microsoft global network also powers all other cloud services from Microsoft, Office 365, Windows, Dynamics, Azure Active Directory, Xbox, Bing, Teams. All these services are powered by the same global network that's serving you. In addition to Microsoft services, thousands of enterprise customers, they rely and trust on this global network to run their mission-critical applications and services. As I mentioned, we have 180 plus edge points of presence, and these edge POPs are strategically placed closest to the user so that we can observe the traffic as soon as possible, route them on our own Microsoft private backbone network all the way to the hosted service region. And then the return traffic also follows the same principle and exits our network closest to the user. So by observing and delivering the traffic to the point closest to the user, we provide premium connectivity experience in terms of latency, throughput, and more. And this is called cold potato routing. And so once the traffic enters to Microsoft network, it stays on Microsoft network. It doesn't flow over the internet. And also, all communication between our data centers, whether within a region or cross region, it stays on our network all the time. Whether it's a communication between a virtual machine or a storage account, or between Azure and Office 365, or between Office 365 and Xbox, all the communications between two Microsoft IP addresses always remain on our Microsoft global network. It doesn't flow over the internet. Another point to call out here is all the traffic between our data centers, whether within a region or across the region, is encrypted automatically at the physical layer. So your data in transit is already encrypted by default. When it comes to cloud, one size doesn't fit all. You have different types of workload, you have different type of use cases. Some workload requires extremely high performance, some workload requires to optimize for cost. And this is where routing preference come into picture. It empowers you to customize the underlying network and letting you to choose the network that is optimized for performance or optimized for cost. Now you have the choice, depending on your use case, you can choose one over the other. So in the previous slide, we talked about cold potato routing. So we have placed our edge points of presence closest to the user globally so that we can observe the traffic as soon as possible, ride them on our own premium Microsoft global network all the way to the hosted service region. And the return traffic follows the same principle and exits our network closest to the user. For example, if a user in Singapore trying to access a storage account in Chicago, so the traffic enters Microsoft network in Singapore itself, then it travels on our own Microsoft private network all the way to Chicago, and the return traffic from Chicago also travels on Microsoft global network from Chicago all the way to Singapore, and then exits in Singapore. So as you can see, bulk of the time, the traffic was in our Microsoft global network. Because it's a premium private global network, we're able to provide you premium quality of service with cold potato routing. But we understand you may have some workload that do not require premium predictability and premium performance of the Microsoft global network. You may need a cost-optimized option for some of your use cases. And this is where routing preference gives you a second choice. So you may choose the underlying network that is more cost-optimized. And in this case, it will be ISP network instead of Microsoft global network. In case of ISP network, we do hot potato routing. If I pick the same example, a user in Singapore trying to access a storage account in Chicago, with the hot potato routing, the traffic from Singapore will take the public internet route all the way from Singapore to Chicago. It will enter Microsoft network in Chicago, and the return path also, it exits Microsoft network in Chicago, takes the public internet route all the way to Singapore. The difference, as you can see, the cold potato routing is using Microsoft global network, and the hot potato routing is ISP network. Performance of the hot potato routing is predominantly dominated by the ISP network performance, and it is comparable to other cloud service provider. Now, how to enable routing preference? For infrastructure as a service resources, such as virtual machine scale set, load balancer, you can enable through the public IP. So when you create a public IP, you will see two routing preference choices there. By default, it will be always Microsoft Global Network, but you have the option to change it to the ISP network. Once you create the public IP, you can attach the public IP to any of these resources, for example, in virtual machine NIC or in the load balancer as a front-end internet facing IP. So based on the routing choice that you have selected, traffic will do either hot potato or cold potato routing. You can also enable routing preference for your storage services such as blobs, files, Azure Data Lake, and the default is always Microsoft Global Network. It gets even better with the support of enabling both routing choices for your Azure resource. For example, for a virtual machine, you can have a network interface with two public IPs, one public IP routed via Microsoft Global Network, and the second public IP routed via ISP network. You can also have two separate network interfaces. One network interface is mapped to your Microsoft public IP, and the second network interface is mapped to the public IP that is routed via ISP network. You can do the same thing for the storage account. So you can optimize for performance, you can optimize for cost, you can do all those combinations. I'm going to give a demo about how to enable both routing choices for your Azure resources for a virtual machine, and we'll also talk about how to enable for a storage account. In this demo, I'm going to include two scenarios. The first one, I'm going to enable routing preference with the ISP network routing for my storage account, and that's going to create an additional endpoint for my storage services. So now I'm going to have two endpoints, one that comes by default, which is always routed via Microsoft network, and the second one created from routing preference is routed via ISP network. Now I'm going to use both these endpoints to access a file from my blob container. For the second scenario, I'm going to enable both routing choices for a virtual machine. So I'll have a network interface with two public IP addresses. One public IP is routed via Microsoft network, and the second public IP is routed via ISP network. Let's start with the storage scenario. I'm here in the Azure portal. So to save some time, I have already created my storage account, and the routing preference option is there in the networking tab. So as you can see, I have already turned on routing preference. If I go to properties, now you can see there is a second endpoint got created because I turned on routing preference for my storage services. So now I have two endpoints. I'm going to access a file from my blob container using both these endpoints. Let's go to the container. So this is the file that I'm going to access using both these endpoints. I have a simple HTML file. As you can see, my HTML file has two URLs, one that is routed via Microsoft Global Network, and the second one is routed via ISP network. Now let me go ahead and load this HTML file on my browser. So let me refresh. So as you can see, the same storage service is now accessible via two separate routing network. So now you have choices. You can use the one that works best for you. Routing via Microsoft network is performance optimized, and routing via ISP network is cost optimized. Now let's move on to the virtual machine demo. Again, to save some time, I have already created a virtual machine. I'm in my networking tab. As you can see, my network interface has two public IPs. One So this one is using ISP network, and if I go back and click on the other one and see the properties, and this one is using Microsoft network. So now I have a virtual machine which has a network interface and is associated with two public IP addresses. One public IP address is routed via Microsoft network, and the second public IP address is routed via the ISP network. Now I'm going to use these two public IPs to access a directory from my virtual machine. So this is my Microsoft network public IP. So if I hit on refresh, so it's fetching the data from my directory. And this one is routed via the ISP network, and I'm going to refresh here. And it's also fetching the data from the directory. Now, as you can see, the same virtual machine I can access using two separate routing network. You can also enable both routing choices for your internet facing load balancer scenarios. That concludes the demo. Let's go back to the presentation. Maps plays a very important part in your internet first strategy to provide the enterprise grade internet connectivity experience to Microsoft SaaS services. Earlier, we talked about Microsoft Global Network reliability, availability, and how it is designed and optimized to provide you consistently high quality of service. Now, to provide end-to-end seamless connectivity experience, we also require optimization in the last mile. So that's the network from your location to Microsoft Edge points of presence. And this is where Maps come into picture. Maps platform solves that last mile problem and enables reliable, high-performing connectivity from your location to the Microsoft network. Maps is a collaboration platform, and we have partnered with internet service providers, internet exchange partners, SDCI providers to provide optimized, reliable, and high-performing last mile connectivity from the customer location to the Microsoft network. To call out some of the key Maps capabilities, first, it starts with performance. The service guarantees that there is only one ASN hop between you and Microsoft network. Second, on the reliability front, local and geo redundancy is built in to provide high availability in the last mile. Each Maps partner is required to have both local and geo redundancy. And each peering location is provisioned with redundant and diverse peering links. Then on the capacity side, each peering needs to have high peering capacity to handle unpredictable demand spikes. Maps also provides a performance telemetry platform, and the service collects a number of network performance metrics, such as latency, jitter, packet loss, and other metrics. Then it processes those data at near real time and aggregates them by first mile, middle mile, and last mile connectivity. So from a customer standpoint, you get network performance insights for network connectivity all the way from your location to the Microsoft cloud service in the data center. Additionally, you can also configure to get notified for performance degradation, route anomalies, route leaks, and more. On the security front, Microsoft has developed an industry-leading route leak detection and mitigation platform, and we call it as Radar. Radar monitors over 20 million internet prefixes at real time every day, and it protects our network against route anomalies and route leaks. Now, Map service also leverages Radar, and it extends the same Radar capabilities to the last mile partner network. Nothing really matters if you cannot connect to the cloud. Maps empowers our customers with strong last mile failover plan for internet connectivity when they're connecting to Microsoft services. Now, as I mentioned in the previous slide, each peering location is provisioned with redundant and diverse peering links. Also, providers interconnect at multiple Microsoft Edge locations in different geographies. So if one of the Edge nodes has degraded performance or in case of a disaster, the traffic routes from Microsoft or to Microsoft via the alternative sites with the same partner instead of going over the internet. From a customer standpoint, configuring primary and backup paths is very straightforward. Customers can look up for their internet provider in Azure portal, and then they can choose the primary and backup paths for their traffic. Thank you so much for joining. If you want to learn more about routing preference, Azure peering service, or other Azure networking services, please visit our website, and there are plenty of materials there. Thank you.